Hi, my name is Ron Layman. I'm from the Faux School in Frederick, Maryland, where I teach decorative painting workshops and complete commission projects for clients all around the world. If you're interested in either classes or commissioning me, please go to the website, thefauxschool.com, and you can find everything you're looking for right there. So today, I'm going to do this really trippy, it's Grasello plaster using black Grasello and the Milano metallic pearl-based plaster from Firmer Lux. So let's get our tools, let's get our materials, and let's get started. The first thing I've done to get ready for today's technique is base coated the surface using the micro primer. Micro primer is an interior exterior primer. If you choose to, it cleans up with soap and water. If you want, you can tint it with pigment, never paint. Put it on with 3/8 inch nap roller, and then I actually sanded it because it still had a texture to it and I want to knock that down because I'm working with Grasello plaster. Grasello plaster, lime base. Tints with lime compatible pigments, earthen pigments, nothing else. Has to be lime compatible. The best thing to do is when you order it from the guys at Firmalux, call them, give them your favorite Benjamin Moore paint color. They'll tint it to match, or they already have a bunch of pre-made colors. Just talk to them and they'll help you out. Always make a dry sample because it does dry lighter. Then, yes, dries lighter. Cleans up with soap and water, interior, exterior. Never tint it with paint, never tint it with paint. And always stir it up, get it nice and fluffy. Okay. So we have our tools, the Pavon trowel and the Pavon spatula. That was a little dirty. We're gonna take, I've tinted the plaster this dark tricorn black from, is it tricorn? No. Yeah, tricorn, Sherwin-Williams. Let's get it out of the can. And what we're gonna do, completely, totally different, non-traditional technique, all right? Gonna be a real cool, this is more of an accent wall, all right? This is gonna be a linear technique. So for the first coat, actually I screwed up. I should come up like this. Start the bottom first. Now I would start here and come down, and this will make sense why. Because as I pull down, it will work with our linear technique. Meaning, if I did it the way I was doing it, you would see my trowel line. So now I'll finish at the top, and you're not going to see where that trowel comes into the surface. Okay. So we're going to let this dry 100%, come back, do the next step of the process. See you in a minute. Okay, we're dry. Second coat, let's get to it. Same thing. Now what we're going to do... No, we're not ready. Yeah, we are. Yeah, I can't think straight. Same thing. Start from the bottom. Ooh, got some junk in there. Ooh, good thing we caught that. Come up. And now we're going to work down into it. That way we don't have any marks from the edge of this blade. And it's okay, it has a little texture to it. It's not going to really hurt much. Okay, let's clean this off. Dig it. Texture tool. Put it in and pull it down. Now at the top, it's going to be very hard to get to your ceiling. You just got to go into it twice. Put it in full. If you don't, the texture will not match from here to there. So take your time. Okay, that's it. Let's go clean this. Okay, so this is starting to firm up. And what I'm gonna do is take my trowel with a very light pressure, very light touch, and just come down and knock down the high spots. So I'm not smashing it completely flat. I'm just laying some of it down. Hold on, I'll get halfway and I'll kind of show you what I'm talking about here. It's gonna be really hard to see because of the black. I don't think you'll see it at all. Can you? No, you can't. So anyway, I'm just knocking down the high spots. So I'm not making it flat, I'm just knocking some of it back. All right, let's continue. And I'm not using it this way because I could get too heavy-handed and really not be good. Now we're going to let this dry 100% and carry on. See you in a minute. All right, so we're completely dry. You can see the difference. Now, what we're going to do is get into the spatula. Actually, I'll be using my spatula in my trowel. But I didn't clean it. So, what I have done, and now I'm working with the Milano plaster from Firmalux. It's the silver base. It's a metallic plaster, and I've tinted it with my mica powders. So I've got micro copper in this one, and on the other side I have my sticker came off, but I know it's bronze. That's weird. Yeah, micro bronze. So in the formulation is half a container of this to a quart of plaster. So what I'm going to do . Where's my stir sticks? Where are my little device here? Get some plaster. Shoot. Sat too long. I should have got in here sooner, meaning it was out in the air. Got a little thick. We're going to start pulling this down. I got to add a little water to it. It's just too thick. It's not the end of the world, but you see how hard it is to work. What happens is that mica powder gets in there. It sucks all the moisture out of it. So, good to know, right? But yeah, you saw what happened. So just get a little water and just dilute it down a pinch. Not going to hurt anything because it's too thick and gummy. It's not going to work how I want it to work. See the difference? So I'm getting like hints of it here and there. That's what I want. I don't want solid streaky lines. I'll grab the other color. They're really close together. Kind of might have to mix up a third color. Just blending. Yeah, you know what? I am. Sit tight, I'll be right back. I'm gonna get a third color to introduce into this. Okay, so what I did is I mixed up a third color of the Milano plaster. Again, Milano is a pearl or the silver lime base plaster. Mixed it with the antique bronze, because I really want to get that, I want to more of a darker color into this. And I need some out, just a little bit on my trowel. Still not dark enough, but it's working. At least we get some. Oh yeah, I can see it. Okay, now let's get our black plaster out while this is wet into wet. We're gonna start doing some fun fresco layering. Al fresco. Because these colors are really super strong. Of course, like I told you earlier, I would come up from the bottom. That way that you don't see my stops on my starts. Getting there. Slowly getting there. Now we're talking. I need what I did first to dry before I continue on, because what's happening is I'm getting too many layers too wet simultaneously, and this is all starting to lift off. We don't want that. So let's let this dry up. We'll see in just a little bit. Okay, so I wanted that to dry down, and it did. What was happening was there was just too many layers of wet plaster on there, and what happens is even though it was firmed up, the new layer was reactivating the layer underneath that wasn't completely dry, and it caused it to peel. So no big deal. But I want to get in here with my little spatula, and I'm going to start creating this. This is plaster. This is the Milano plaster that I'm working with. And this is tinted. This is the copper one. See, it didn't mix it up very well, and you can see the plaster actually right there. But you know what? That's working. I'm digging it. I'm probably going to bring the base right into this. Oh, I'm loving that. Absolutely loving that. See? Happy mistake, and it works to our advantage. Into the dark bronze. Same thing. I'm gonna grab some black. That fell over. It's the beauty about just kind of experimenting with some things. You never know sometimes how things are gonna work out. I knew I was going to go somewhere with it. I absolutely digging this. Yada yada. Tint base. I am blown through this product. The Milano, that is. I love it. Need to whip this up really good. But you know what? It's time to stop. I think I'm liking this the way it is. And if I do any more, I'm not gonna like it. I know. What does it look like over here? It's like a muddy freaking mess. Oh my. Gotta whip that up. Interesting. From what I see on the monitor, I don't like it. I have a feeling this is going to be one of those, like... You know, sometimes you make something, it just doesn't translate well in photograph or video. And I'm almost done. Actually, you know what? That's it. You gotta know when to stop. I can keep playing with this and playing with this. And I'm making one big giant mess here. Not good. Could be worse. Let's see what it looks like up close. Now remember, when that black is gonna dry, one was charcoal. So let's go dry this down. And then we can make a determination. All right, see you in a minute. All right, it's dry. I know from where you're sitting, it looks like a mess. This one doesn't come across very well, and it's, I'm sorry for that, but I'm not gonna wax it. I'm just gonna leave it just the way it is. I like that. Look. Not even gonna burnish it. Let's see here. Maybe I will. Now the only thing I would do different is I would use bigger spatulas than, all right, bigger wall, bigger spatulas. Nah. I don't think I'm gonna mess with it. This is a hard one. Probably it's a love hate. Look at it. Just imagine that on a wall. Accent wall. I know, very bold, very lot happening. Let me bring it in here closer so you can see. I'm into it. Very cool finish. Very modern. There you have it. I don't even know what to call this. You can see all there's the metallics. There's just a tint base. A lot going on. Definitely practice this. I mean, Actually, I could see this in a dining room, a really hip dining room. Great nightclub finish. Restaurant? Yeah, I could see that. All right, but that's it. There you have it. Real quick, if you don't mind, go down below, hit that subscribe button so you know when I make new videos, or you're notified when new videos are coming and when I do the live videos. And if you don't mind, hit the like button while you're down there. My name is Ron Layman. I'm from the Faux School in Frederick, Maryland, where I teach decorative painting workshops and complete commission projects for clients all around the world. If you're interested in either one, there's a detailed class schedule on the website, and there's a whole section there about projects that I've completed from the Kennedy Center, International Monetary Fund, Hollywood Casino, you name it, to everybody's house. Not everybody, I need to update it. But anyway, you'll get the drift of it, and you can contact me there for commission projects and order products as well. But I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.